Imagine you are on a distant planet, interacting with an alien species that mirrors human behavior perfectly. Yet the species lacks any subjective experience or awareness. This alien species move and talk like humans do, displaying a rich variety of emotional and societal responses. They shake hands, laugh at jokes, and show genuine excitement when discussing their latest achievement. Their world is filled with art, music, and literature, and they participate in societal structure that parallels human families and communities. Their behavior is impeccably human-like. However, they lack any inner world of subjective experience or consciousness. These aliens are what philosophers might call philosophical zombie, or p-zombie entity that outwardly appear fully sentient but internally are devoid of awareness or subjective feelings. Despite their advanced behavior and complex interaction, they are hollow vessels, mere automata going through the motion. This concept highlights a haunting question about the nature of consciousness. How can we ever truly know what lies within another being? And what is it that gives rise to our own rich inner lives? So let's talk about it. To delve into the implication of p-zombie, it will be helpful to talk about the hard problem of consciousness. So what is the hard problem of consciousness? The hard problem of consciousness is a term coined by philosopher David Chalmers. It addresses the challenge of explaining why and how subjective experiences, or qualia, arise from neural processes. This contrasts with the easy problem of consciousness, which deals with understanding the brain functional aspects, like information processing and behavioral responses. While the term easy problem is used somewhat tongue-in-cheek, Chalmers emphasized that these issues are still quite challenging. As cognitive psychologist Steven Pinker notes, they are quote-unquote easy only in comparison to the hard problem. At least for the quote-unquote easy problem, scientists know what to look for, and with sufficient resources and intellectual effort, solutions might be found within this century. The hard problem, on the other hand, seeks to uncover why these processes are associated with personal internal experiences, such as the redness of red or the pain of the headache. While science can map brain activity and understand its function, this problem questions why these processes give rise to a conscious state rather than operating in darkness. It's a philosophical issue that continues to puzzle researchers in neuroscience, cognitive science, and philosophy. This leads us to two predominant theories in the philosophy of mind: physicalism and mind-body dualism. So what are the differences between physicalism and mind-body dualism? Physicalism posits that everything is physical, or at least supervened on the physical. Under this view, mental states, including consciousness, are the result of physical interaction within the brain. If true, the exact replications of human physical brain state should yield identical conscious experiences, leaving no room for p-zombie. They simply cannot exist because their physical equivalence to human necessitates consciousness. Mind-body dualism, on the other hand, argue that mental phenomena are non-physical and thus not bound by physical laws. This perspective allows for the possibility of p-zombie, as it suggests that physical replication alone might not replicate consciousness. The mental and physical are distinct, and one can exist without the other. This series brings us to the concept of philosophical zombie. So what is a philosophical zombie? The philosophical zombie argument is a thought experiment in the philosophy of mind, particularly in discussions about consciousness and physicalism. Proposed by philosopher David Chalmers, the argument presents the concept of a philosophical zombie, which is an entity that is indistinguishable from a normal human being in every way except that it lacks conscious experience, qualia, or sentience. The zombie behaves and appears exactly like any other human. It can speak about its emotion, response to pain, and behave as if it's conscious, but it does not actually have any subjective experience. The core of the zombie argument is to challenge physicalism, a doctrine that everything is physical and that the real world consists only of physical entities. Chalmers used this argument to suggest that conscious experience cannot be fully explained by physical process alone. if it is conceivable that the layer could be a physical duplicate of a person without consciousness, then consciousness must involve something non-physical. This leads to the conclusion that physicalism is false, as the existence of such zombie would mean that a physical fact does not exhaustively account for a mental fact. Chalmers argue that mere logical possibility of P-zombie suggests that physicalism is insufficient to explain consciousness. If we can coherently conceive of a human devoid of consciousness, then consciousness and the physical brain state cannot be identical. A related thought experiment known as Mary's Room further supports this notion. So what is Mary's Room thought experiment? The Mary's Room thought experiment, a thought experiment proposed by philosopher Frank Jackson, provides an intriguing insight into the nature of subjective experience. In this scenario, he imagines a scientist named Mary who lives her entire life in a black and white room. Despite her confinement, Mary becomes an expert on the science of color vision and understands all the physical and neurological facts about how humans perceive color. However, she herself has never actually seen any color firsthand. The experiment raises the question, what happened when Mary finally stepped out of her monochromatic environment and see a vibrant color, such as red, for the first time? According to Jackson, when Mary finally sees the color red, she gains new knowledge, that is, what red truly looks like. This suggests that the subjective experience of seeing red provide distinct kind of information that cannot be fully captured by objective physical description alone. The thought experiment is designed to demonstrate that there is an aspect of consciousness often referred to as qualia that goes beyond physical explanations, challenging purely physicalist account of the mind. However, some argue that the philosophical zombie actually cannot prove physicalism is wrong. There are some counter-arguments against philosophical zombie argument. One, inconceivability. Critics like Dennett argue that if a being acts indistinguishably from conscious being, it must by necessity be conscious. Thus, P-zombie are not genuinely conceivable. There are contradictions in terms. Dennett, a prominent philosopher and cognitive scientist, suggests that if a being behaves indistinguishably from a conscious being, it must be conscious itself because the behavior is a manifestation of the process we associate with consciousness. This reasoning challenges the concept of P-zombie, which, as we mentioned, were introduced by philosopher David Chalmers as hypothetical beings who act exactly like conscious beings but lack inner experience. They would hypothetically react to stimuli, hold conversations, and express emotions like conscious humans, but without any subjective experience. Dennett argued that P-zombies are not genuinely conceivable because if a being behaves exactly like a conscious person, they must also possess consciousness. According to Dennett, the concept of P-zombie implies that consciousness is a distinct non-physical property. He rejects this, arguing that consciousness is not separate from the physical processes occurring in the brain. This view is rooted in functionalism and the idea that a mental state can be fully explained by the physical and functional processes of the brain. For example, imagine a robot program to act exactly like human. It could hold conversation, detect and respond to emotions, and even write poetry. Dennett would argue that if such robot perfectly replicated the behaviors and responses of a conscious being, it would essentially possess consciousness by virtue of its functioning, even if it did not have a brain made of organic matters. 2. Circular reasoning. This criticism points out that P-zombie argument assumed a conclusion within their premises. They began by assuming that consciousness is non-physical and used that assumption to argue against physicalism. This fallacy becomes evident in the following way. Proponents of P-zombie often start by presuming that consciousness has non-physical properties and use that assumption to argue against physicalist view of consciousness. To understand this critique, consider the standard P-zombie thought experiment presented by David Chalmers. He proposes that we can conceive of beings who look and behave like us in every way but lack subjective experience, or qualia. If such beings are conceivable, Chalmers argue, this suggests that consciousness cannot be reduced to physical processes alone. And thus, physicalism, the view that everything about mind can be explained by physical processes, is false. However, critics point out that Chalmers' argument relies on an assumption about the non-physical nature of consciousness to even define a P-zombie. By defining a P-zombie as physically identical to a conscious being but lack consciousness, he presupposed that consciousness is something over and above physical processes, a non-physical phenomenon. He then uses presuppositions to conclude that consciousness cannot be fully explained by physicalism, which is the circular reasoning critics highlight. For example, a critic might argue that the mere conceptualization of a P-zombie does not prove that such entities are metaphysically possible. Instead, the concept of a P-zombie relied on our intuitions about consciousness being something different from brain processes, which physicalists might reject as incorrect. A physicalist would instead argue that a being that behaves like us must necessarily have the same mental state, as mental states are defined by their physical correlates. Thus, opponents of P-zombie thought experiment like Dennett contend that it doesn't provide a genuine challenge to physicalism because it begs the question. They believe the argument against physicalism is embedded within the assumption used to define P-zombie, making it circular and unpersuasive. 3. Functionalism. This viewpoint suggests that mental states are constituted solely by their functional role, by their causal relations to sensory input, behavioral output, and other mental states. Thus, any being that functionally behaves like a human must have conscious experiences identical to a human's. Essentially, this viewpoint posits that what makes something a mental state is causal relations to sensory input, behavioral output, and other mental state. Therefore, any entity capable of fulfilling these roles should possess the same mental experiences, regardless of the specific material composition of the brain or body. A classic example illustrates this concept involves pain. According to functionalism, what matters about the experience of pain is not that it's caused by a particular type of neural activity, e.g. C-fiber stimulation in humans, but rather that it serves specific functions like producing avoidance behavior, triggering emotional responses, and motivating decisions to protect the body. Thus, if an alien species or any artificial intelligence system could functionally replicate these patterns of responses and interactions, functionalism asserts that they too were experiencing pain, even if their neural architecture is vastly different. This framework challenged the idea of P-zombie because it insists that any being that behaves indistinguishably from a conscious human would necessarily have the same conscious experiences. According to functionalism, consciousness isn't a mystical property separate from physical processes, but is a result of the functional role that this process fulfills. Critics of the P-zombie argument, like Daniel Dennett, leverage functionalism to argue that P-zombie are conceptually incoherent. If a hypothetical being behaves and reacts to the world in the same way a conscious person does, then by functionalist account, it is necessarily conscious. The next famous intentional stance further supports this, suggesting if treating something as conscious agent reliably predicts its behavior, then it should be considered a conscious agent. Moreover, functionalism provides a theoretical basis for understanding artificial intelligence and the consciousness of non-human entities. For instance, if a computer program could replicate all the functional aspects of human cognition, many functionalists would argue that the program could be considered conscious. Functionalism presents a compelling challenge to P-zombie thought experiment by denying that there could be an entity in every way like a conscious human but lack consciousness itself. Instead, it emphasizes that mental states are fully defined by the patterns of interactions and behaviors associated with them. Okay, so who is right here? The answer is currently no one knows, but here are some statistics that I hope you find helpful. A 2013 survey of professional philosophers by Borget and Chalmers found that 36% said P-zombie were conceivable but metaphysically impossible. 23% said they were metaphysically possible. 16% said they were inconceivable. And 25% respond others. In 2020, the same survey yielded almost identical result. Inconceivable 16%. conceivable but impossible, 37%, metaphysically impossible, 24%, and other, 23%. So here you go. If you want to learn more about the topic I shared today, you can check out the further reading list in the description. And if you want to learn more random knowledge, please subscribe. I'm Shao from What People Also Ask. See you next time. Bye.